Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the North American stock markets for Friday morning. This is going to be my last video for a week or so. It's very quiet out there. There's not a lot of people watching the videos right now. And so this is the time of year where we take some time off, and we'll be making charts next week. We will not be making pre-market videos. In the pre-market this morning, things are fairly quiet out there. Not a lot going on. Price of crude oil is up slightly this morning, so that's a good thing. We've been talking about the U.S. dollar. A potential change in trend in the U.S. dollar could help commodities. After taking out the May highs, we were able to run up one more line and stop. And the high of that move was signified by a bearish reversal day, and we started to come down. We're on a sell signal right now. And so that should be supportive for higher commodity prices at some point. Right now, it is not having much effect on the price of crude oil, but it is helping the price of gold, which has been on a buy signal for the last couple of days. Pros are starting to take control of gold, and that's a good thing. Not that significant. They've taken control before, and it hasn't lasted very long during this bear market. And so we'll just have to see if we continue to get follow through to the upside. The next tell for the price of gold is if we start breaking out above $1,125. Looking at the stock market, still nothing going on here. The VIX for the S&P 500 is still trading through the upper channel line. The VIX for the NASDAQ is still on a buy signal, no change there. So that's a bearish outlook for those markets. Looking at a 60-minute chart of the S&P 500 cash index, you can see back in the middle of July, we once again traded through the 2125 level and quickly failed. The run down that we had took us down to a significant low, and that low was actually higher than the previous valley. So that actually was a bullish sign that the market might be able to go back and retest the recent high. When it did, it actually failed. And so here we put in a lower high, and that, of course, is bearish. And then we came down, had a nice retracement. And for the bulls, that looked bullish, the fact that we made an actual higher low. And then this is where things start to get dicey for the bulls. We made another lower high, then a lower low, lower high, lower low. And now it looks like we're putting in another lower high here. And if that is the case, then expect a lower low sometime next week. Looking at the three stocks that people ask about the most, number one is Apple Computer, still on a sell signal, no change here. A close above 118.70 on Friday would give us a new buy signal for Apple Computer, not expecting that to happen. The second most popular stock right now is Netflix, and we need to close on Friday below 117.22 to give us a sell signal there. And the third stock is Tesla. Tesla recently generated a buy signal on the close. And then, of course, the next day you came in and looked at it in the pre-market, and it had gapped lower below the lower channel line. So hopefully you just waved off that signal and walked away. On Friday, we're looking for a close above 253.25 to give us a buy signal. And of course, if we don't get that on Friday, that upper channel line is going to continue to move lower daily. Now, looking at the Canadian market, the TSX is back on a sell signal as of Thursday's close. It mostly has to do with weakness in financial stocks, but also energy stocks rolled over on Thursday. We were looking for energy stocks to continue to move higher, and that could certainly happen over the next few days. We're still on a buy signal in the U.S. looking at the Amex Oil and Gas Index. Still on a buy signal for gold and silver stocks in both Canada and the U.S. A turnaround day yesterday didn't take out the previous day's low. Both crude oil and gold are up this morning, so we'll have to see if we get continued buying in the gold and silver sector. The open gap has been played through, and so that open gap is no longer in play for the TSX Gold Index. And you're seeing a lot of gold stocks play through that open gap as well. Now, there are a bunch of gold stocks showing up in the most active list on the New York Stock Exchange right now, which is unusual. It happens every day on the TSX, of course, but not the New York Stock Exchange. And so out of the most active on the New York Stock Exchange top 100, we've got IM Gold is the best performing of the big cap gold stocks, while Newmont is a drag on this sector at the moment. and certainly a drag on the XAU. Let's finish off this morning with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. We're coming into Friday on an intraday sell signal for the TSX. That would change on Friday with an hourly close above 14,298. For the S&P 500, we're coming in on an intraday buy signal. That would change on Friday with an hourly close below 20,80.69. For the NASDAQ 100, sitting right on the edge of a new sell signal, an hourly close below 45,18.81 would give us a new intraday sell signal. And for the XAU, we're coming in on an intraday sell signal, and that would change. You can see we traded into this open gap here and are using that as support right now. That would change on Friday with an hourly close above 51.25 to generate a new intraday buy signal. A couple of more charts on the XAU. We have been able to trade through the hourly flypaper channel, but have not been able to break out above the 200-hour moving average. We spent a couple of hours above it, then quickly reversed. And now we're looking to see if we can hold the 50 and the 100-hour moving average. And of course, we still have that open gap overhead. Didn't test that the other day. And so now that is still in play. And we'll have to see if we can break out above that open gap. But that will certainly help us. If we can break out above that open gap and the 200-hour moving average, that will certainly confirm that new money is coming back into this sector. Okay, folks, that is all for this week. And unless there's a huge move in the market next week, I won't be doing any pre-market videos. May do some other videos, but nothing in the pre-market. And if things are fairly quiet, we might continue that into the next week as well. The viewership of our videos when we post them right now is very, very low, and that is seasonally what happens. A lot of people spend time focusing on their families and are off on vacation this time of year and really don't have time to watch stock market videos. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again soon.